permanent pacemaker implantation. So a permanent pacemaker insertion plays a key role in the management of heart rhythm disorders and heart failure. So if the patient has a heart block or any rhythm abnormality, so first we will be inserting a temporary pacemaker insertion, and the temporary pacemaker cannot be kept to the patient body for a long time. So once the person is reverted to a normal rhythm or the normal sinus rhythm and everything is okay, so the patient can lead normal life. And if you, when you are checking, the heart rate remains depending on the pacemaker, better plan for the permanent pacemaker implantation. Definition: pacemaker is an electronic device, approximately looks like a size of the pocket watch, and sensors the intrinsic heart rhythm and provides electrical stimulation when indicated. So what is a pacemaker insertion? So the pacemaker insertion is an implantation of small electronic device. So mainly it will be placed on the chest wall externally, subcutaneously, to help regulate to slow electrical problems with the heart. What is a pacemaker? So the pacemaker composed of three parts: the pulse generator, one or more leads, and an electrode on each lead. A pacemaker signals the heart to beat when the heart is too slow or irregular. So it will be doing as an automatic thing. So whenever the patient heartbeat is going low, so automatically it will be spontaneously the pacemaker started working to regulate the heartbeat. Here you can see the pacemaker, that is the pulse generator. So in the temporary pacemaker, the pulse generator will be kept external, and only the thing in the permanent pacemaker, we will be placing the pulse generator in the subcutaneous and the leads. So that is a single chamber that will be depend upon the patient's condition, that doctors will be decide in the cardiologist whether it's a single chamber or dual chamber or triple chamber. And when we are keeping the pacing wire, mainly we will be focusing the right atrium or left atrium or right ventricle, and never pacing wire should be inserted in the left ventricle because the left ventricle pressure will be high. So a pulse generator is a small metal case that contains electronic circuitry with a small computer and a battery that regulate the impulses sent to the heart. So coming to the indication, pacemaker may be inserted in order to stimulate a faster heart rate when the heart beating is too slow and causing problems that cannot otherwise. So sometimes some patient, even if you are giving them inotropes or adrenaline, epinephrine or norepinephrine, the patient may sustain. But even after giving a medication for a long time, the patient may not be recover. So better we will go for a permanent pacemaker implantation. So the indication, bradycardia. This occurs when the sinus node causes the beat too slow. That is, we call it as less than 60 beats per minute. It's a bradycardia. And tachybrady syndrome. This is characterized by alternating fast and slow heartbeat. So if your some patients may not be having a neutral rhythm or a normal rhythm. If you are seeing, sometimes the heartbeat or the heart rate will be high, tachycardia, 140, 160 like that, and suddenly they will be dropping the heart rate, which will go suddenly less than 40 or less than 60. So this type of patient only matter we will be monitored by like that Holter monitoring. So they will be fluctuating heartbeats. So this type of patient also there will be needed a permanent pacemaker. Then heart block. So that is the interruption of impulses from the SA node. That is, this occurs when the electrical signal is delayed or blocked after leaving the SA node. Then risk of the procedure. The risk commonly, if there may be a bleeding from the incision or catheter insertion site. So if you are not properly visualized, there may be a chance of damage to the vessel of catheter insertion site. Then even there may be a chance of getting infection of at the incision or catheter site. The pneumothorax. So because it nearby lung is advantageously punctured during the procedure, there may be trapped in the pleural space, the patient will go for a pneumothorax, air in the thorax. And the patient also allergic to sensitive medications, and some patients may having to lie on the procedure table for the length of the procedure may cause some discomfort to the patient, because sometimes it may be taking long time. So that's what commonly the permanent pacemaker implantation should take 3 to 5 hours. So it may cause some discomfort to the patient, and there may be other risk depending on the specific medical condition, that any other comorbid factors that should be initially discussed with the cardiologist. And what we should do before the procedure, patient will be asked to sign the consent form, notify the doctor if they are sensitive to allergic to any drugs or contrast agents. And the patient has to fast, so the patient should be kept oral before the procedure from 12 midnight, and in case the patient is pregnant, they should notify the doctor. And whatever the medications, any medications already the patient is taking, any antiarrhythmic drugs or antihypertensive drugs or oral hypoglycemic agents, everything should be notified to the doctor. And notify the doctor if they have any heart wall disease or may to receive any antibiotic prior to the procedure. And even notify the doctor if they have a history of bleeding disorder, or if they are taking any anticoagulant medication, okay, so heparin, anything, acetrom, anything, if they are taking, there may be a chance of bleeding. So that should be discussed with the doctor, or even aspirin that affect the blood clotting. So this type of medicines usually will be stopped before the procedure. And the doctor may request a blood test before the procedure. So commonly if the patient is on anticoagulant, antiplatelet therapy, so better we can do PT, PTT, INR. And the patient may receive a sedative prior to the procedure to relax, and if sedative is given, the patient may be possibly, that a patient may be discharged and likely to spend at least a night in the hospital. And we have to monitor whether the pacemaker is working properly. So what happens during the procedure? So the patient will be asked to remove any jewelry or other objects that may interfere with the procedure, and all the clothing will be removed, and the patient will be changed to hospital gown. Asked to empty the bladder prior to the procedure, and if there is any excessive hair at the incision site, it should be clipped off or shaved. And we have to start the intravenous line in the hand or arm prior to the procedure. And any injections, pre-medication, anything is there, we should be given. And the patient will be placed on back on the procedure table and connected to the ECG. And we will be continuously monitoring the patient heart rhythm and the vital signs like heart rate, blood pressure, breathing rate, and oxygenation level will be monitored during the procedure. And large electrodes pads will be placed on the front and back of chest, and the patient will be receiving a sedation medication through IV to relax. And most of the patient will be awake even during the procedure, but they won't feel the pain, and the pacemaker insertion site will be cleaned with the antiseptic soap. And that exactly the incision area, sterile towels and a sheet will be placed. A local anesthetic will be injected into the skin at the insertion site, and we have to make it sure whether the patient has the thing anesthetic effect. The physician will make an incision at the insertion site. Then a sheath or introducer is inserted into the blood vessel, usually under the collarbone. And the sheath is a plastic tube through which a pacemaker lead wire will be inserted into the blood vessel and advanced into the heart. And it will be very important to remind still during the procedure, catheter does not move out place and prevent damage to the insertion site. So whenever we are inserting the catheter, everything will be visualized through the fluoroscopy on the monitor, so that the doctor will be giving a guidance of where exactly they are going. And the lead wire will be inserted through the introducer into the blood vessels, and the doctor will advance the lead wire through the blood vessels into the heart. So once they're confirming that the lead wire is inside the heart, it will be tested to verify proper location and it works. And there may be 1, 2, or 3 lead wires inserted. That is depending upon the type of devices. That's what already I said. It may be a single chamber, dual chamber, or triple chamber. That will be depending upon the patient condition. And here the fluoroscopy X-ray may be used to assist the tester. So the fluoroscopy X-ray, that is everything will be monitored in the screen. And the pacemaker generator will be slipped under the skin, that is the subcutaneous, just below the collarbone, after the lead wire is attached to the generator. And the generator will be placed in the non-dominant side. So usually the doctors will be keeping on the left side of the chest, left side, the subcutaneous. And in case if the patient is an they are right-handed, it will be placed on the it will be placed in the upper left chest. And in case that the patient is, if you should ask whether they are left-handed, because what will happen means after inserting the pacemaker, the patient may be find very difficult to move the arms. At least 3 or 5 days we should strictly insist the patient should not move the particular arm. So in case that the person is a left-handed patient, better we can keep it in the right upper chest. Then the ECG will be observed to ensure that the pacer is working correctly. And after that, the skin incision will be closed with the sutures, adhesive tapes, strips, or a special glue. Then sterile bandage will be applied or dressing will be applied over the suture site. Procedure. After the procedure in the hospital, so after the procedure, we will be shifting the patient to the recovery room and closely monitor the patient, and we should ask for whether the patient is feeling any chest pain or tightness in the chest or any pain in the incision site. Then complete bed rest, and in case the patient want to get out of the bed, always need the assistant. And then here we have to assist the patient whenever, and make sure that the particular incision site never take BP, and the patient can move slowly, get up from the bed with the help of assistant. And the patient will be able to drink or eat once they are completely awake. And the insertion site, commonly it will be painful, and the pain medication may be administered, and the doctor will be visiting the patient, and specific instruction will be given at the time of getting. Once blood pressure, pulse, respiratory rate, everything is stable, that the patient can discharge. And if the procedure is performed in outpatient basis, at least they have to complete the recovery process at least one night that the patient has to stay in the hospital. At home, after a few days, the patient can do the daily activities, but avoid strenuous activities like lifting, pulling, and the patient may be instructed to limit movement on the particular arm. They may be most likely to be able to resume normal diet, and that insertion site, ask the patient to keep the insertion site clean and dry, and special instructions should be given what they have to do at the time of bathing and showering. And special instruction will be given about driving. Always the patient has to carry the ID card. And always they have to interact with the doctors if they are having any doubt, and consult with the doctor about their occupation, overall health status and progress. And notify the doctor to report any of the following they feel. If the patient develop fever or chills, or any increased pain, redness, swelling or bleeding, or other drainage from the insertion site. If they are feeling a chest pain, pressure, nausea, vomiting, profuse sweating, dizziness or fainting, or palpitations. Then pacemaker precautions. So some of the precautions should be considered. So always carry an ID card that states patient have a pacemaker. In addition, may want to wear a medical identification bracelet indicating they are having a pacemaker. So whenever the patient is driving or going for a long journey, or that they are doing any occupation or work or anything, always they have to keep an ID card or an ID, bracelet, which indicates the name of the patient and the pacemaker, type of the pacemaker inserted, and the working condition, and when the battery will be getting explored, like that everything will be indicating in the ID card. Then let screeners know the patient have a pacemaker. So if the patient is going for airport, any security detectors, if they are having, unless they are having an ID card, they may not be aware that the patient has a pacemaker. Because what will happen, it's a metal device. It may lead to sometimes if you are nearly going to the security detectors, it will be giving alarm. So if they are selected for additional screening, handheld detector devices, it will be, since the patient has a pacemaker, it will be giving an alarm. So politely remind the screeners, so always at the time of screening, they should politely, the patient has to tell the screeners that the patient has a pacemaker. Then, so if there is contacting with any magnets, it may affect the function of the program. So that it may be started affecting the function of the pacemaker. So everything should be informed to the screeners and so that they can be aware. And patient may not have the MRI procedure because they should avoid large magnetic fields as the power generation sites and industrial sites. Then abstain from diathermy, the use of physical therapy to treat muscles, and always turn off large motors such as cars or boats, and we should advise the patient should not go close to them. Then avoid high voltage or random machinery such as radio, television, electric welding welders, high tension wires or radar installators or smelting furnaces. And in case if they are about to do any surgical procedure, always they have to inform the surgeon they are having a pacemaker. Then ask also, they can ask the cardiologist whether anything special should be done or any electrocautery device that controls bleeding. And sometimes what will happen, if they may be fixing the program may be changed temporarily. So to minimize the possibility of interference, so always consult with the cardiologist. And even when involved in a physical recreation or sporting activity, always tell the patient they have to make sure to protect themselves from trauma to the pacemaker. Because what will happen, in case the person is having a pacemaker, if they are going for a batting, bowling and all, sometimes anything blow to the chest near the pacemaker can affect the function. So always they should be alert. Such type of things should be avoided. Thank you.